With the latest release of Kali Linux, installing it on a Raspberry Pi 5 like this, it's a piece of cake. Let's find out how it's done. In order to install Kali Linux, there are two methods that we can follow. One of them is to go to kali.org, click Get Kali, select ARM, and here you'll find the image for the Raspberry Pi 5 64-bit. Just click on the arrow and you'll download the image. Once that is completed, open Raspberry Pi Imager, select Raspberry Pi 5, choose OS, go here and select Use Custom Image, and then you can select the Kali Linux image you have just downloaded. The other option that you can use, it's a little bit different. The same selection of Raspberry Pi 5, and on Choose OS, you have to go to Other Specific Purpose OS. You will find Kali Linux image already listed here. This is an online image download, so you'll get the latest release available. Just click on it, choose the storage. In this case, I'm gonna choose my attached SD card. Click on it. Next, I do not want to use any OS customizations. Even if you want to edit the settings or create a new custom settings, they will not work. For some reason, they do not apply to Kali Linux, so just choose no. Do you want to erase the card? Yes, and it will start writing. We're gonna use some internet magic to speed it up, and it's done. Click continue. We can now move the SD card to the Raspberry Pi 5. Let's see if it starts, shall we? Alright, we're at the login screen. I have here a wireless keyboard. The login and password is Kali. And the system booted up without the issues. We have a touchscreen on the system, so we can access the menu, go through different applications, we can even start one. It works just fine. The only issue that we have with the touchscreen is that Kali Linux by default doesn't support an on-screen keyboard. We'll have to enable that further on the line. But otherwise, everything works okay if you can get adapted to such a small screen. So it's a really nice setup. All the network connections work. One thing to keep in mind is that if you want to use the system for any wireless tools, do any packet captures and so on, the wireless card on a Raspberry Pi, it's not supported for those features and you would need to use an external USB wireless device. Other than that, you made yourself a very portable system. If you do not need the screen, you can install Kali Linux, put it in on a small box, and you can you can connect remotely to this machine. You can plug it in anywhere on a socket, connect to the wireless network and just dial in when needed. That's it for this short video. I hope that you found this useful, and if so, please don't forget to like and subscribe.